Hi everyone, welcome back. Just hanging there because this is our last talk for the second session before we take a break. I'm Sharon Omoja, I'm joining you from Nairobi, Kenya. This talk is on why OSM is not known more widely, about the consequences of not enforcing attribution requirements. Our speaker is Mateusz Konieczny. Thank you, and please remember to use the question section to post your questions for the speaker. Enjoy the session.
Hello. I want to describe one of our problems. Solving it will make OpenStreetMap known more widely. I want to start saying a bit about myself. I'm a quite active mapper, mostly mapping what I encounter while cycling, hiking, and walking. As a programmer, I to improve several OpenStreetMap related programs. It is likely that you use some of the features that I implemented, especially if you map with StreetComplete, the Android application where mapping can be done by answering simple questions. I make significant contributions there. I also improved other software. My latest project is a 3D tactile map for blind children and ones with a poor eyesight. And I want to start my presentation from a big thank you to everyone who is using OpenStreetMap data and has honestly tried to credit authors, the mappers. For example, Wikimedia Commons app. It is making easy to contribute photos on open license to, well, Wikimedia Commons project. It used to have no real attribution, but now it is fixed. And I want to thank them because it is fine to make some mistake and later fix it. And here is the quite good attribution. And OpenStreetMap maps are appearing not only on screens, but also on, for example, information boards. I really was pleasantly surprised by this one. I had opportunity to map an OpenStreetMap map, and it is not fully ideal, license is not mentioned, but it is far above average, and I'm really happy to encounter something like that. And one more case. And here is also the attribution. And one more case, the Osmand. And here I primarily like a quick reaction. After pointing out that they should attribute OpenStreetMap more prominently and giving a clear idea how to improve the situation, it was fixed basically immediately. And to be clear, that examples is not a full list. There is not enough space to list all. And there are many, many other examples where it worked fine. So I want to thank again to thank to everyone who placed a clearly visible attribution, also on mobile devices. But sadly, it is not always happening. For example, I had an encounter with a pair of tourists. They had some trouble figuring out the bus route, and while we were at the bus stop waiting for their line, we talked a bit. Somehow, the discussion ended on the topic of maps. I mentioned and described OpenStreetMap. They commented that it sounds like an interesting project, but it seemed to them to be an unnecessary duplicate of Maps.me with its great maps that they were using to navigate across multiple countries. And they were completely unaware that all useful data displayed by Maps.me is from the OpenStreetMap. And important part of the situation is that duty of people who made MapsMe was to ensure that people will be aware of it, of the source of the data. It is one of few conditions required to be able to use the amazing resource of OpenStreetMap data. To be more specific, it is mandated by ODBL, the OpenStreetMap license. And it can be argued that MapsMe is technically mentioning the source, but it's the better important part first. MapsMe credit is shown all the time. And the OpenStreetMap credit is kind of worth one. First of all, it is blocked by internal ad at the start. That would be not a big problem, but it's shown only for 2 seconds. So it is basically never shown fully. And MapsMe text is shown forever. And in addition, MapsMe is ignoring a report about the problem for 2 years. In the meantime, the company was sold and app stopped being open source and many weird changes happened. This problem remains unfixed. And why it even matters at all? We need more mappers. And I'm pretty sure that OpenStreetMap would benefit from more mappers, especially hobby mappers mapping their areas. And plenty of things can be said about what may discourage people, starting from general society issues. After all, someone unable to pay for food, shelter, and basic necessities is quite unlikely to become involved in a time-consuming hobby. Or being told your whole life that maps are not for women is going to have some effects. And it is not going to have a positive effect on how many women are going to join a map-centric project. And many things can be improved in OpenStreetMap itself. Improving community so more people want to join and stay. And there are also more technical issues. For example, try to register for an OpenStreetMap account on a smartphone. The registration form is basically a self-parody. On mobile devices, on the main OpenStreetMap website, the edit button does not mention existing apps, directs to desktop software that is unusable on mobile. And editing software also can be made much more user-friendly and effective. That is why I'm involved in making Street Complete. But all these things, how community can be improved, how to achieve that and how it can go wrong, plenty of things can be said, so I will not go into detail here. But all these things matter only if someone is aware that OpenStreetMap exists. People unaware that OpenStreetMap exists will not join to map the world. And OpenStreetMap community has right to demand the attribution. It's a duty of people using our data to ensure that people will be aware about what is the real source of the data, that the data is not some property or work of the app maker, of the hosting company, of some organization using OpenStreetMap data. It is coming from another project and it is very useful for many reasons. But first, I want to kind of disclaimer. First of all, not every use of the OpenStreetMap data is requiring attribution to be present. For example, if I take a single node, single position from the OpenStreetMap data and use it as an example illustration in, say, tutorial, or just I wanted to take random location, then it does not require attribution when I have a private use of OpenStreetMap data. For example, I make an illustrated private diary that only I will use, then attribution is not necessary. Or sometimes there are more general rules that the license does not apply at all. For example, if I take a photo and in the corner there is a tiny, barely visible, accidental map coming from OpenStreetMap data, it's not necessary to attribute it specially. But these are kind of unusual cases, and when someone is can be described as using OpenStreetMap data, the license is necessary. For example, if I publish an app and people can download it, and I have a map in this app, then attribution is necessary, a clearly visible attribution. If I make a map and give it to a friend as a gift, as a decoration, the attribution is mandatory. In some cases, in very narrow private use, can be skipped but if I gave to another people that I am not employing, that I am not controlling, then the attribution is necessary. When I put map in a public place, for example, an information board, the license is necessary. But one more disclaimer for entire thing. I am not a lawyer. I want to repeat that if someone needs a legal advice from lawyer, then they should obtain their lawyer, and I am not a lawyer, so there is a kind of limit to my understanding, but license is quite clear, and I'm quite sure that first, ODBL license of OpenStreetMap data requires a clearly visible attribution. And second, that many uses of OpenStreetMap data are not including such a clear attribution. So, to kind of answer the title of the talk, what we would gain from more visible attribution, as it should be. First of all, more people will contribute. First, some people will learn, notice that the OpenStreetMap exists. Second part, when they will keep noticing that OpenStreetMap data is source in their navigation app, in a location map, in the bus, on all maps, in events on Facebook, on another navigation app, in movies, in art, they will be more likely to contribute because they will be aware that this data is actually used, that it makes sense to help a bit, and that is not some hobby one person project that is unused by anyone and it's not worth investing time in it. And second part, that the currently you need to be quite weird to notice the OpenStreetMap to become aware about it, I'm pretty sure that we'll have much more diverse contributors if a more wide group of people, more standard demographics would be aware that the project even exists, that it is used. Right now, there is an extreme overrepresentation of certain groups, and I suspect that it is that would be significantly reduced if more people, more representative group of people would be even aware that OpenStreetMap is existing. And I mentioned so far and complained about Maps.me, but it is not single project that is entity that is a problematic. On the OpenStreetMap wiki, there is entire quite long list. I also had my own list for the especially problematic cases. And I want to mention a bit some of them. For example, Snapchat. Snapchat is quite widely used, and they are using OpenStreetMap data. They are not attributing it. I sent an email 2 years ago. It was basically ignored. As they are Mapbox users, I reported via Mapbox form that supposedly was can be used to report missing attribution on map of the client. I got info that they gave Snapchat some unspecific deadline. I sent reminders 1 year, 2 years later, and it was ignored. Last time I checked, quite recently, while I was making this presentation, the attribution is still gone, and it is quite cleverly hidden. On the web, when you open website on their map, the attribution is shown, but when you use their app, like most of people, then it will be invisible. And Mapbox itself. Mapbox is helped a lot in making OpenStreetMap data more available, but they are not very active in proper handling of attribution. This example is from their own website. They remembered to put an attribution to Mapbox itself. Mapbox is attributed by itself 3 times. Or for if you count also logo. To see OpenStreetMap attribution, you need to click on this weird black button. And it is something that will be not done by normal user. So it is not sufficient to fulfill attribution requirement. When you click on this weird button, you will actually see the attribution that would be perfectly fitting into screen by default. But on the less pessimistic view, in many cases, reporting works. You can send a simple email, and in many cases, many users are actually fixing the problem. For example, this air ambulance landing map had Google logo. It is not fully fixed, but at least they tried and improved it a bit. One more example, the open data listing maintained by European Union. It was crediting some European Union organization for OpenStreetMap maps. And now after simple email it is fixed, and now the attribution is not ideal and not perfect, but it is much better. On another case, this one is from my city. The press release was not mentioning the OpenStreetMap as source of the map. Now, this specific problem in this press release is fixed, and this is an example of what kind of email I am sending. So it is not necessary to have it very long, very complicated, or have it 2,000 pages long. For many, and it is just a reminder that they are making mistake, that they can fix it easily, is enough to trigger a change. So it often works, but in some cases, mapper, random person on internet sending emails will not work. For instance, some examples that I gave before, and OpenStreetMap Foundation can and should act in such cases. And why this happening? For example, let's take case of Facebook. And Facebook is in business of selling screen space on screens of on smartphones and computers of people using their services. So there is conflict of interest that is resulting in Facebook not showing real attribution even on a full screen map. It is even worse than what Mapbox made on their own website, because here even the button itself is quite invisible. And it is worth considering what would be the value of an ad under every single map on Facebook, especially as is not would we not be some irrelevant ad. The map itself is also a great depiction that the data is useful. How much it would cost, and OpenStreetMap is entitled to such a clear notice, a clear attribution. And it is entitled just because Facebook is using our data. And we should be aware that there is this conflict of interest, and it is in our interest to have a clear attribution on maps using OpenStreetMap data. And it is not in interest of many users to show a clear attribution, because it is taking space from ads, it is taking space, is making a page uglier, it is requires a bit more work to fit. And I admit I was also tempted when I was making my own a map as a gift to skip the attribution, but I included it. It would be the map as a decoration would be nicer and prettier without some weird random text in the corner. So I'm aware that there is a conflict of interest, that putting attribution is making some maps a bit uglier, a bit maybe there is less space for other important things, for example ads, or other less evil things that someone wants to fit. But let's make OpenStreetMap known more widely. We can ask users to clearly state the source, and the OpenStreetMap Foundation should act in cases where such reminders are not sufficient. Because right now we are losing potential contributors as bonus in a way that preserves unusual demographics of OpenStreetMap, and we are losing chance to grow awareness of the OpenStreetMap, and would be useful to be recognized as important, useful project for many reasons. And I want to thank again to everyone who is actually clearly attributing OpenStreetMap. And English is not my native language, so if you see some tragic mistakes, let me know, and next time I will try to avoid them. And the text of the talk and slides are published on this on my website. And I want to thank everyone for hearing.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Mateusz, for an amazing talk and for your advocacy on OpenStreetMap attribution. I will jump straight into the questions. The first question is, if OSM or the Open Database License requires all users of the data to show the copyright hint directly on the map itself and not behind a link, doesn't that mean that any other Open Database licensed data can be used for OSM because not all data sources can be listed on the map? In other words, open source database license is not compatible with itself.
As mentioned, I am not a lawyer, so I would prefer to look into a bit more, far more than I have did during the talk and a bit before, because I was also a bit curious about it. One thing is, it seems obvious that it should not be possible to take entire OpenStreetMap database and release it as a little green star project, also ODBL license. It seems to me that it obviously should not be possible, but it's quite weird that ODBL database cannot be used. I looked quickly and I have seen that the ODBL license allows to distribute data on the ODBL itself, but I am not entirely sure. It should be possible. If I would be importing some database, I would ask the authors of the database whatever they would be whatever it would be okay for them to be attributed as one of anonymous contributors we've mentioned just on the wiki on the contributors listing. But please discuss it with someone who knows more, because this part that I'm not really sure how to really interpret it. I could look into it like I looked into attribution itself when I tried really hard to not make some dumb mistake and misinterpret what the license says. Here I would need to look into it far, far more to be comfortable to say anything about it.
Great, thank you. The other question is, on mobile devices, the attribution links are annoying as I keep tapping them accidentally. Should there be a recommendation to ask for confirmation before opening the OSM site?
It seems to me that it should be really fine to ask user, are you really sure to that you want to see details of license? Personally, if I would be implementing it, I would mention, I would put the attribution text OpenStreetMap on ODBL license, and as I understand it, it would be allow me to skip the link itself. But I also would recheck it before implementing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, that's great. We have another question. Aren't you essentially advocating fixing a more general marketing issue, which undoubtedly exists with legal means that are unsuitable for the purpose, not implying that attribution should not be provided, but that it is the wrong tool to address your specific grievances? If not, counterproductive.
In my opinion, is I have a bit experience with trying to convince local government to do various things, usually basically related. And in my experience, trying to convince someone that they should do because it's a good idea is possible, but takes massive amount of time but pointing out to say local government that what you are doing is literally illegal and you can stop breaking law by these simple steps, then usually the reaction is much, much, much quicker. I have seen quick reaction only for cases when you could be described as this and this situation is causing direct danger to life or health of people. That is also very effective, but it's not applying to attribution. And applying laws is in general the proper solution for dealing with corporations. There is a long history of entities, large entities, usually companies, corporations, but also others that break law in various ways. And it's were doing evil things that were not even breaking laws and enforcing laws and or even introducing new laws is a standard solution for dealing with it. And I'm not really buying argument that we should be careful about feelings of Facebook or Snapchat. They are big entity that is not people involved have feelings. It's not it's not a good idea to start some kind of witch hunt or attack people or trying to do someone against specific people. But Facebook is not going to do something because we ask them. I also tried it. It obviously failed. But enforcing law is standard thing to do with a large entity, large company that is violating it. If someone is ignoring question to put license, and is not going to help if we ask them more carefully. So I think that is our right to have a license. If someone wants to really avoid license, I guess they need to log own data because Google also requires to put attribution. There are some public domain data sets, but nothing is as good as OpenStreetMap, and they either can follow our rules or not use our data. And I think that is perfectly fine to remind them about it.
Oh, great. Our next question is, are you essentially... Not that, I'm just sorry. Our next question is Snapshot not attributing OSM at all, or is it just hidden somewhere?
Okay, I linked in the chat the non-app version, and here the attribution is appearing at all. It's also, I'm not 100% happy about it because it's not mentioning that the hosting and map styling is done by Bamox and data is from OpenStreetMap, but is at least mentioning OpenStreetMap, which is nice. But in the app itself, maybe it is hidden somewhere, but when I went into settings, it started to ask me to give them a permission to access my location and I think contacts and other things. So I would need to set up a separate phone for testing it. But I have not explored it fully, but it certainly is not appearing on where it should appear. So question is, Snapchat is attributing address on a website. Not sure is it hidden somewhere in the app.
Yes, and I have the same question on booking.com because I always thought booking.com uses OpenStreetMap data on their site, and I always don't see attributions anywhere on their maps. Do you have any idea on that?
I have no idea at all. Okay, I think I have seen mention of OpenStreetMap somewhere on booking.com, but I haven't really explored it because maybe I'm trying to start with cases where attribution is completely utterly missing, not where someone at least tried to do something sort of. So maybe I just was not investigating it further because there was some really, really poor attribution. But I'm not really familiar with booking specifically. I'm not often using it.
Oh, great. Thank you. The other question that we have is, what is the legal consequence of training AI algorithm with open database license, OSM data. Any potential similar issues like with GitHub Copilot or open source code laundering?
Okay, in this case, I'm not going to say to ask a lawyer because it is a very big unsolved issue and it is a gigantic upcoming legal quagmire, and I'm betting that will end in various new laws or decision by the highest courts, because it is really tricky to differentiate. Is it just copying data? Is it just training data? Because when I look on some map and later map the same location, and I'm subconsciously using this data, is that does not mean that that Google is copywriting my OpenStreetMap mapping just because I looked 2 years earlier on the same data. But at this, but in the Copilot case, people managed already to convince it to just copy the source code explicitly. So I'm going to answer that is a very interesting legal issue that some lawyers are definitely going to earn massive amount of money on litigating it. And in this case, I'm going to say I'm not a lawyer and going to just say that if you copy data, then it's definitely copying data and putting it through Paint or through a neural network or through other fancy solution is not canceling the fact that it's copying. But creative transformation, when it starts to be counting as new data, when it's a license, I have no idea. I'm not going to answer it, and I'm betting that no one can really answer it.
That's so great, and thank you for the amazing session, Matthias, and your advocacy on decent attributions. For more interactions with Matthias, please go into the Open Talk chat room, and that's the end of our second session today. We'll take a break, and the third session starts at 20 hours UTC. See you then. Thank you.